Let's give you the northeast one they won't show again. So you got to watch the shadows and stuff. And I've got it going backwards, I guess, right now. So I'll hit step and hit start, and then we'll just get going here. Watch the back here. You'll probably see some glimmer again. But you're going to see another sun come up again. It's not the moon. And you'll see the moon at the nighttime giving a good you'll see a shadow of the tower again, which is made out of different materials than what we originally were given the picture of what they had there. So, like I said, if it's German, it's going to be made of steel. There's steel on that thing. Or aluminum, one way or the other. So, you see they get a moonlight, and then that's not the moon there. So, basically, I'm going to bring that back real fast. And they get some pretty good gusts. It really got... as the sun's coming up, and I think I've already went by it so fast, it comes by so fast. I'll show you the sun coming up. Super giants in the sun. In the morning. Okay. And we'll go back a little bit. And this is a color camera. That's the sun coming up. Okay. I just went back a little bit so you see that there is a color. It is a colored camera. Okay. There's the sun. 610, 620. And then when it comes by, it's all ammo. And then if I go another frame, it's just going to disappear. So we'll go in real fast on that there. And then I'll go 999. And that's at 999, and then we'll take and hit the magnifier on it. And that is not any planet. That is a second sun. Get a good look at it. Tain't no planet. And more than likely, there's probably some good odds right now. If it disappears, we don't see this for a while, then that probably is Panstarrs, and Panstarrs probably was a falling star, not a comet. All right. So, factual. It's at Nehemiah. Remember, they don't give you the northeast one right now. Okay. And remember, they're on the shore of Antarctica pretty much here. So, I mean, the shore is just a little ways away. I don't know if it's like 4 or 5 football fields away. And so, and there you went. You seen the second sun come up. That's what I zoomed in on. All right. Back up again a little bit. Sorry about the tapping, but we're just bringing it back real fast. There you go. And you can see the sun glimmering on the tank again. So they're not wanting us to see what's at the other camera. So, gone. I'm going to take it down. As you see, they get a pretty good, whip of it. Pretty much whips up by, whips up the snow and everything with the energy. So that's another sun, ladies and gentlemen. Panstarrs, more than likely. But then again, it could be what we've seen up by the sun for a long time too, when it was black at a certain direction and angle. So there's way more than one sun. That's a natural fact. There's almost an infinite amount of suns out there in space. So they bleed through. They are magnetically connected to each other. And we get dragged behind the sun. And the sun is on its way back in the Milky Way galaxy, pretty much, very slowly. I mean, it's hauling ass, but the Milky Way galaxy is so flipping huge. So, anyway, this is all actual factual. And that's there. No matter what you do. Okay, even at a lower resolution, like getting in on a lower resolution, and then you don't get the finite core of it that you seen earlier when I added up on 999. So that's there. So it's nice when I go in on 999 first, give you a real good shot of it. You can still see it, the core of the yellowness of the middle of it right there on that shot too. So I just thought I'd give you another day of it, and we'll see how many days it does do of it. And Neymar scientists and stuff like that, would it be nice if you fixed it? I know there's nothing wrong with your camera, but you're giving us the frozen shots. Just a frozen shot, not even getting the pictures. So I'm not getting the film, we're not getting the pictures. So anyway, thanks for this footage. It's awesome. And